Hello guys, it's my Minic with relation to real estate. I'm a realtor in the state of Arizona. I'm also licensed in California. And I got some feedback on my videos that I'm too serious, which I'm definitely not. I'm not totally not serious, but I'm definitely cool. And I'll try to kind of show that more in my videos. But you know, this is very, for me, this is very serious, like buying a home, which is your biggest investment ever. So I really take this seriously. That's the reason maybe I'm being a little over serious. But, and you know, we are talking about serious thing about the money, you know, and I don't, you know, I don't joke about that. So last couple episodes, we talk about, I'll be coming here every week to talk about some current real estate trends, or like if I have a questions from the clients, I'll go over that question. So we start with the buyer process, like steps 1 to 10. And today, last couple episodes, we talk about writing offers, negotiation, and today we're going to talk about going actually under contract, which means the buyer and sellers agreed on terms and they went under contract, as it, the same word says. So as soon as we that happen, we'll have to deposit earnest money with a title company, and then they're opening the escrow. We have 24 to 48 hours to do that. After that, I like to order inspections as soon as possible. So I have a couple great inspectors who I work with, and whoever has the fastest, you know, availability, will go with them, or I will definitely give you a couple options so you can decide which way you want to go. And after that, we will, and that's only because we have only 10 days to do our due diligence regarding inspections of the home. So I like to, if we, and usually we need a pool inspector, roof inspector, AC specialist, plumber, electrician, different estimates, so we can ask seller to do all these repairs or give us a credit. It really depends on whatever you prefer. After all of that, we will go and after MLS will show under contract, and after, or under contract accepting backup offers, which means that they're still open for, you know, like if you, for whatever reason, you know, during that 10 days inspection, if you change your mind or whatever happens, so they have kind of backup offer. After that, when all contingencies are removed, which we'll talk more about in next episodes, but then it's gonna go pending, and then we are like more sure that we're gonna close in time and that we'll close. So that'll be it for today. I hope you know you found this informative. And if you have any other questions, you can directly message me. I'll be happy to sit with you and talk more about. And if you need a realtor, you know who to call. Thank you. Have a great day. Bye.